Warning. This video has an overabundance of badassery and beautiful scenery. If you're boring or don't like pretty places, this video is definitely not for you. There's also plenty of dark humor, so if you're easily offended, click off this video now. The rest of all you cool people can stay. Enjoy.
What's going on, guys? My name is Halbin Minaya, aka Cashflow Entrepreneur, and on this video, I will be recording my journey to Terrenas with my friends. And as you can tell, I am very sick, so before I go, I have to hit the doctors first to get some analysis done and see what it is that's wrong with me. I've been feeling really ill, some flu, headaches, fever, and I went through emergency the other day because I just couldn't stand it no more, and they said that it could be a virus transmitted by the mosquitoes, so I can't really take too much sun, or I can't really be around the wind too much because it could get worse. So I'm gonna go pick up my aunt first, I'm gonna go put some gas, then I'm gonna hit the clinic, and then I'm gonna get some analysis done, so then we can drive for like 3 hours to the place. So this should be fun. But now I just came to pick up my aunt at her place. Gotta park over here because the streets are so small that they can't really pass if you're on the way. Oh my god, the lighting is awesome over here. So let me just turn down the camera because I'm recording from my phone. You see how small the streets are, and two vehicles are supposed to go through there. Oh my god, I didn't notice I had lotion over there. Just waiting for her to come out. So this should be a fun ride. It's about to be 1:14 and we're about to get on our way to Terrenas. We got my brother in the back. Yeah, probably already seen him in the previous video. And then we got my aunt over here. Tia, say hello.
Hello.
So you already know, we're about to pick up the results and all of that. So I got a little prank coming for my aunt. See how she would react to it. I'm about to load up a gun without, it doesn't have anything inside. I'm gonna pass it to her. She's a little nervous. So we're gonna see how she reacts to it. Teo, ¿te sabes la inseguridad y la vaina? Aquí un lío, ¿eh?
Sí, sí.
Aquí hay que andar con dos ojos y vaina.
Ah, eso te iba yo a decir. Por ahí, cuídense.
No, hay que cuidarse y vaina.
Ajá, cuídense porque allí, ahora mismo ustedes son, aunque sean dominicanos, son turistas, ¿viste?
Pero yendo con usted, tía, a mí no me atracan con usted.
Ay, ay, ¿por qué no me se van a atracar? ¡Que no!
Mira, tía, agárrala ahí.
Ay, no,
agárrala ahí, tía. Agárrala ahí, tía.
Ay, no, déjala ahí,
agárrala.
Que no.
Tira, tira para arriba, tío.
Ay, no.
Ay, un tiro.
Ay, no. Ay, qué va. Miren.
We're buying the groceries for our stay at the Airbnb in Terrenas. We have my boy Marvin over there. You got Sandel. I know you guys know him already. And then now we have a little problem. Because where the fuck are we going to put all of this? Where are we going to put all of this?
La fiesta no para pena comienza. C'est comme ça, c'est comme ça. Ma chérie, la 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 la. Francia, Colombia.
Alright, so after a 4-hour ride, we're finally here.
Mm,
Finally here. Oh, by the way, here is my brother's friend. I mean, my brother's girlfriend, my dad, Patricia. And yeah, my brother over here too.
I'll just give you guys a little tour. A little tour of the Airbnb we got. A little living room. A little kitchen. What is that over here? Is that like a little closet or something? No, this is a, oh shit, the laundry room.
Yeah, I told you we had a laundry room.
Yeah. Open it up right there. So there's this room right here.
Oh, yeah.
Is that otra habitación?
Yeah.
Right here. No, right. This other room.
Pero mira aquí.
Hell, this is crazy. Little closet. No view.
Put this right in. Oh shit.
Somebody's in the bathroom? Oh, yeah, somebody's
in the bathroom. I think you guys only had those two.
No. Have the terraza. Yo, how do you say terraza in English? How do you say terraza?
What?
How do you say terraza in English? We don't know. I think this, you can take it off. And then there's a pool in the back. Build the hammock. Boom, 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 boom. Wow. Let's see. You guys won't be able to see the pool because it's obviously night, but there's a pool over there, which I'm gonna show you guys tomorrow.
Y nos vamos. All right. So this is day one at Terrena. Have Marvin in the back. Patricia. Sunday. Today we're gonna be going to the beach. We are gonna exchange money right now, so we can have enough to spend, obviously, right?
Estamos rompiendo la discoteca, la fiesta no para pena comienza. C'est comme si, c'est comme ça, ma chérie, la 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 la. Francia, Colombia, me gusta.
Freeze. And Terrena. Y Balvin, Willy William. And I'm gonna be shooting another video.
Oh, what the hell is this? So this is supposed to be the wave for a restaurant. Let's see how it is, right? Yo, there's no way I'm coming through this way at night. Esquina, esquina, y ahí nos vamos. El mundo es grande, pero lo tengo en mis manos. Estoy muy duro, sí, ok, ahí vamos. Y con el tiempo nos seguimos elevando. Que seguimos rompiendo aquí. Esta fiesta no tiene fin. Botellas para arriba, sí. Los tengo bailando, rompiendo, y yo sigo aquí. Que seguimos rompiendo aquí. Esta fiesta no tiene fin. So let me give you guys a little look of the beach over here. This is Samana. We came to a little kiosk to eat first because we were so hungry. And then we will be going to like fancy restaurant at night. We're gonna dress up and all of that. Here's the water is so fucking like see-through. It's crazy. All right, so story time. Yesterday, when we were on our way over here, we were stopped by, like, there were like six cops in motorcycles. Obviously, we stopped. We went to like a little spot so like we can like see what's up, like why they stopped us, right? So they basically asked us for our names, our licenses, and a little thing over here is that they don't have to have a reason to stop you. Like, they'll just stop you out of nowhere, and they'll just, like, check your vehicles without any orders or anything like that. So, like, you have to be kind of, like, okay with it. But most of the times, they do it to get money from you. So, let's say you don't have anything, and if you don't want to wait a lot, or if you don't want to get locked up for no reason, then you have to give them, like, $20 to let you go. But, thankfully, I do have some contacts where I'm staying at that are, like, higher-ranked cops. So like anytime I get stopped, which I've gotten stopped like 2 times already, I can just call them and then they can just let me go. But yesterday I was stopped like an hour from where I'm staying at, and that's the capital. So as I said, there was like 6 cops. There was 2 in each side. So there was 2 in the left, 2 in the right, and there's 2 in the back, making sure that I wasn't like gonna like escape. So we did stop, we asked what was the reason why they stopped us. They were like, oh, we're just doing like a regular checkup and all of that. And at the end they were like, oh, we're not gonna ruin you guys' vacation, just give us something so we could go, because one of us is our birthday today or something like that, so we could buy like a little rum or something, and you know, you guys can get on the way to whatever you guys are heading. So we had to give them like 500 pesos, which is like $20. So we didn't have to be stopped there for such a long time and stuff, which I'd rather do that, because yesterday we were late since I had to get the analysis done, which I don't have anything serious. It was, it's just a cold that got in me bad. And yeah, that's about it. So they let us go. Then we went to do the grocery shopping over here, since we are staying at an Airbnb, so we have to like do all the cooking and stuff like that. And by the time we arrived over here, it was like a 3-hour ride. And mind you, you guys are gonna see in the video how like dangerous the curves are, like the way over here was. So by the time we got over here, we were so tired. We just like we watched a movie, went to sleep. I worked. And then today we came to the beach to eat something, to a little kiosk that I'm gonna be showing you guys shortly. And then tonight we're gonna be going to another restaurant, and maybe tomorrow, I hope, that's gonna be sunny so I can ride jet skis and like do parasailing and all sort of stuff like that. So, just so you guys can see. And I do apologize because I am a newbie making vlogs. This is actually going to be my first vlog, the trip to Terrenas. So if you guys see that I get off track or anything like that, just know that this is my first vlog. All right. I'm honestly so thankful for me being able to take advantage of the opportunities that have shown to my life. Because if it wasn't for that, I would still be working construction and not being able to come on a vacation to the Dominican Republic, to this beautiful, beautiful place, right? As you guys know, most of you guys, I haven't worked a 9-to-5 since I was 15. Now, I don't want to reveal my age right now, but it's been quite a while, right? It's been quite a few years since I've worked a 9-to-5. And the first one I had was, I was working construction for like $20 an hour from 6 in the morning to like 3 in the afternoon. And it was just awful because sometimes they will make us work an hour, 2 hours more, and they wouldn't pay it. And basically, nobody in the company would complain because the company was filled with people that didn't have any papers. So if they did complain, they're probably just gonna kick them out, and you know, it's super hard to find a job if you don't have your papers in order, right? Obviously, I'm not one of them. I am an American citizen. So I did end up leaving that company as soon as I had enough money to buy my computer, which is where everything started. And I still have that computer with me, still run fast, I still do my job with it, right? And yeah, I am very, very thankful for all the risks that I've taken, for all the people that have allowed me to help them, and I am just super thankful to have a very, very supportive mother, because even at that young age, she supported me without knowing what I was into. Like, she didn't really know what being an entrepreneur or having a social media marketing agency was like, but she supported me regardless, because I always gave attention to my priorities. So I always went to school. When I was in high school, I always had, you know, decent grades that were good enough to, you know, to pass, I guess, and to keep my mother happy. But she didn't really care about them. But yeah. This is the second restaurant we went to, because the other one, they were being too slow. So we left and came to this one. So we are at the beach. Came to the beach. This is called Playa Bonita. And it's beautiful. So it is day two in Terrenas. And today we're going to go to Beach Rincon, I believe. I'm gonna try to rent some four wheels and stuff to show you guys around. And yeah, right now I'm just waiting for the crew so we can leave. By the way, this is the car we've been using. It's a Kia Q5. It's what they call it over here. It has a different type of gas system where it's like more economic. Like, I know it has eco, but the gas they use is not the one that we put up over there in the United States. So let me just give you guys a little show around, and then later I'm gonna give it a wash so I can show you guys the whole car inside out. This is the back of the place where we're staying at. We have the pool, we have other condominiums around, stuff like that, and then that's like a little bar over there. That's our spot right there. First beach of the day. So freaking windy. And look at the current. The waves are so big. I think it's dangerous. Alright, so we decided to come to a place where they rent four wheels and things like that. So we could rent one for a whole day. It's about to be like $50 a day plus like a $500 deposit in case anything happens. The one we're gonna rent out is that orange one right there. If you guys can see it, right? Yep, that orange one right there. They have a whole bunch over here. They are just really nice. They actually rent for like $60, but I talked it down to $50 with the boss over here, with the owner. And yeah, this should be fun. So here's the four-wheeler I ended up renting. It's like $50 and a deposit of $500 in case something happens to it. Finally got to the restaurant. We eaten fried fish, beans, fried plantains, white rice, and salad. Qué delicious.
Todo good, todo correct.
Ha ha ha. 9:05 p.m. and I'm dressed like a whole tourist because we are going out to a beach bar to enjoy our last day in Terrenas. Let me just remind you, today is Saturday.
We're right here. We're gonna shoot some videos, okay?
Alright, so today is Saturday, right? No, today's Friday.
Thursday.
Oh yeah, Thursday. Tomorrow we head back, and then Sunday we're going to. Are we going to Sunday? My friends are gonna take the car, and I'm gonna take the motorcycle. Let's see how that goes. We have Marvin the driver is gonna be the Uber for tonight, and then we have Patricia in the back, and she's gonna be with Sandel. They have their personal Uber tonight. And bodyguard. Vamos a Steve.
Wow.
We ended up coming to this restaurant called Campo Kitchen. So Dominican food over here. And then later, we are going to check out the club over here. No, this is so beautiful over here, watch. Oh my god, look at this. They're having the best time. Too hard. That's why we're sitting inside. Street and Terrenas. Or again, there's a bunch of restaurants over there. Most of them are closed. There's some clubs and stuff. Most of these little restaurants are closed, but I imagine that during the day this looks super beautiful because just like it has like that United, not the United States style, but like most of them houses are made with like wood, so it gives it that essence, that what's it called, that touristic essence, right? Or a sense, I don't know how you say it, but it's all the way down there full of filled restaurants. And there's a few clubs over here. I think the whole crew is over here. Let's see. Oh yeah. This is super like fancy. It's a good club. Super fancy. There they are. This is another club that we came to, but it has Dominican music. I guess a little bit better, right? Got a lot of tourists dancing and stuff. Kind of love it. And sadly, it is time to go already. We already checked out of the Airbnb, so now we gotta put our stuff in the car so we can head back. Marvin, how was Terrenas? How do you like it?
Awesome.
You loved it? I was driving the four-wheeler. He loved it. So just a little recap. Little living room, back up spa, kitchen, bathroom. So first bathroom. This is the room where I was staying at with Marvin, and this is the room where my brother was staying with his girlfriend. And this is their bathroom. Gotta pick up and leave.
We ready? Yo, how do you guys like Terrenas?
Oh, beautiful.
You guys loved it? Buzz and pizzas over here.
Well, it is time that we say bye to this bad boy already. I just dropped it off. Gonna pick up my deposit bag because nothing happened to it. That's how it works over here. I don't know over there. You live a deposit, you pay the day, and then if nothing happens to it, they give you your money back. It was fun while it lasted. Look at this beautiful view. Seguimos rompiendo aquí. Esta fiesta no tiene fin. Botellas para arriba, sí. Sigo bailando, rompiendo y yo sigo. Que seguimos rompiendo aquí. Esta fiesta no tiene fin. Botellas para arriba, sí. Sigo bailando, rompiendo. ¿Y dónde está mi gigante? Me fue a bullshit la tente. ¿Y dónde está mi gigante?